How are you today? I hope you are fine. Well, today is Tuesday, our last 7th of July. It's Ringo Starr's birthday. By the way, we're going to start with Unit 9. Yes, okay, this is our last day because, you know, next class is holiday. Yes, it's the 9th of July. Yes, so we are going to focus on vocabulary, computers, future perfect continuous. Some vocabulary I will focus on. Yes, we are going to highlight all the grammar charts. You are going to go to the grammar reference on page 155. Yes, we are going to work on pages 90, 91, and 92 from the class book. And this is the holiday homework. You are going to do from the list, this is in the cuadernillo, you know, at the beginning you have the list of compositions, all the compositions we are going to work, yes, then you have an appendix, yes, or with all the linking words. Yes, I really like this appendix, I have already used it, yes, when I studied, yes, and it's a very complete appendix. Yes, then you have useful language for letter of complaint, letter of apology, yes, and it's very, very complete, yes, so I want you to, the points you have to consider when you are writing, yes, okay, and it's very, very, very nice, yes, okay, until page 16, yes, okay, I really like it. That's why I introduced in this quadrant. Yes, you're going to do compositions number 1 and number 18. Tiene fecha de salida hoy y fecha de entrega el 28 del 7. Y hay una tercera composición que es una composición de la página from page 53, exercise 5. Okay? So, if you go to the list of compositions in your cuadernillo, you have composition number 1 is an essay. Si no te acordás cómo tenías que escribir un essay, vas a ir a la parte de atrás del libro y te vas a fijar toda la organización y el vocabulario, el formato que tiene que seguir un essay. Y luego vas a escribir. Good and bad points of using internet between 140 and 190 words. And you have the mass words there. Then you have composition 18. Yes, composition 18. And it says, write an article and you will do the same. Read format, read the style you have to follow. Yes, and write an article. Your school magazine has asked students to give their opinion on whether cell phones should be used in the classroom. Yes, 120, between 120 and 180 words. Yes, and then you have on page 53, yes, you have exercise, yes, write your own article. Yes, tenés que leer el ejercicio acá, el uno, eh? Read the exam task again. Animals in danger. Write an article. Yes, write an article. This is the one from page 53. From the exam maximizer. Yes, it says, animals in danger, write an article about an endangered animal in your area or country saying why it is in danger. Yes, okay. Entonces, elegí uno de los animales de nuestra área, yes, que esté en peligro de extinción y sobre ese personaje, sobre ese animalito va a ser ese article. 140 words. Y nos quedamos ahí, ¿está? Is it clear? Yes, right. Los otros, a ese le voy a poner que quiero hacer 140 palabras, ¿sí? ¿Está? Well, and then you are going to do pages 17, 18, 19, 23, 24, 25, 26, 33, 34, 67, and 90 from the cuadernillo. Lo que te sugiero es que, por ejemplo, la página 90, tenemos conditional, second conditional and third conditional. Que arriba le pongas el condicional second, que es pasado, más good infinitive, más good past if plus past, past good infinitive, yes. Y el conditional 3, if plus past perfect, yes, plus would have, la tercera columna. Conditional, second conditional, if I had studied, I would, if I studied, I pass this, I would pass the exam. Conditional 3, if I had studied, I would have passed the exam. Y después te pongas a completar los conditionals. No hagas todo así, a la bartola, porque si no, no le vas a sacar provecho a los ejercicios. La idea es que saquemos provecho, a los que le saques provecho a los ejercicios. Por ejemplo, en el 16, página 17, reading, entonces todas aquellas personas que estuvieron con notas regulares en la parte de reading, esta, this is your opportunity, yes, esta es tu oportunidad. ¿Para qué? Para que subas tu nivel, para que subas tu score in the reading. Pero si no lo haces, si lo haces todo, no lo haces a conciencia, no te voy a poder ayudar. No te vas a ayudar vos tampoco. Entonces, 17, 18 and 19 son readings. Y después, a partir de la página 23, 23, viene ya la parte de grammar. Yes, okay, perdón. En este caso, tenemos word transformations, yes, ok. Acordate que puse este ejercicio para que vos, con la palabrita que te doy en negrilla, en negrita, me digas lo mismo. You must use two words only. Dos palabras solamente, yes, ok. Por ejemplo, te da el mismo. That CD player is too expensive. That CD player is not cheap. Yes, ok. Is it clear? Complete the second sentence in each pair, in each of these pairs, so that it has a similar meaning to the first sentence using the word. Do not change the word given. You must use two words only, including the word given. Yes, okay. Con la palabra incluida. Yes, okay. Two. You must use two words only, including the word given. Follow stages. Yes, okay. Is it clear? All right. Yes, okay. Good. Bueno, y así con las otras. Tenemos la página 24, for example, on page 24, que vamos a practicar tenses, ¿sí? Otra vez más práctica con la palabra que te da y qué frase tenés que sacar. Así que en eso quiero que prestes mucha atención. Después en la page 25, yes, complete with tenses, yes, okay. The story is a dream that Alice has when she falls asleep in the afternoon. Read the extras and put the verbs in the correct tense, okay. So, pay attention. Tenses, you will practice tenses there. On page 26, yes, choose the correct expression. You have alternatives there. Then you have page 33, de ahí saltamos a la 33. Yes, okay, past simple, past continuous, present, past perfect, or past perfect continuous. So you practice all the tenses again. So if you have, if you are having problems in tenses, this is your opportunity. Yes, okay, to work consciously. 34, be used to, and used to. Entonces ahí tenéis la diferencia entre lo que solía hacer y no hago más ahora y lo que estoy acostumbrado a hacer. Be used to, acordate, más verbo en con ing. I am used to working, my mother is used to cooking early in the morning. Yes, okay. Then we have 60, nos vamos a la para page 60. 67, yes, okay, 67, and you have to practice comparatives, Yes, okay, more, less, more and more. Yes, okay. It's getting more and more difficult. Yes, she's as beautiful as her aunt. Yes, and then you have page 90, that could be the last one. Yes, and you have to practice second conditional and third conditional. Yes, okay, cada uno sabe donde tiene más problemas. Okay, well, shall we go to unit 9? This was the explanation of the, and then you have happy winter holidays. La idea es que vayas haciendo un poquito cada día y que no hagas todo al final. Organizate cuando vas a hacer los writings, organizate cuando vas a hacer, por ejemplo, si tenés acá 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Hace dos páginas por día o tres páginas por día, tres páginas, 3 pages from the grammar, one composition, the other day, 3 pages from the grammar. No es mucho, pero necesitas organizarte para sacarle provecho. Quiero decir una cosa, a finales de esta semana les van a ir llegando al WhatsApp de los papás las report cards, las libretas de calificaciones, la edición digital. Al final de este año se les va a dar, como siempre, la edición en papel. Si Dios quiere, nos vamos a volver a ver y todo lo demás. Una cosa que quiero decir para que quede claro y para que nos pongamos las pilas para la próxima parte de lo que tenemos del año. Necesito que estén presentes en las clases. Presente en las clases. La persona que no está viendo el video está faltando a las clases, está rateando de las clases. Entonces, persona, alumno que no viene a la clase, que tiene ausente, va a tener problemas en dote, en la parte de la gramática, en la parte de la oralidad y en todas las skills, ¿sí? Entonces, yo me doy cuenta, ¿sí? Me doy cuenta cuando no están viniendo a clase, cuando no están asistiendo. Entonces, voy a poner una leyenda abajo, cuando mande la libreta, que charlen los padres con los chicos que no están mirando las clases, que no están asistiendo, ¿sí? Hay que mirar la clase en su totalidad, no la parte que a mí me interesa o la parte que explico la tarea. Y eso se nota en las actividades que están haciendo. No todos, porque por otra parte hay gente muy responsable que está haciendo las cosas como debe hacer. Entonces, yo estoy haciendo mi trabajo, que no se les haga una bola gigante que después no la puedan manejar, ¿sí? Entonces, cumplan con su trabajo, que es asistir a las clases, mirar las clases. Hoy por hoy el tema está así. Yo voy a seguir avanzando con la gente que quiere y que le pone ganas y que es responsable para seguir avanzando. El resto va a poner excusas, que el método no le funciona. Acá no hay ningún nuevo método. Acá las clases, vos has sido mi alumno desde hace rato, son las mismas, ¿sí? El tema es que ahora, por la situación en la que estamos viviendo, te tenés que poner más las pilas y ser responsable. No puede haber un policía a la edad que tenés parado al lado tuyo. Mamá, papá, alguien que esté controlando en casa. Así que ya saben, avisen esto en casa. Otra cosa, por otra parte, si yo mando al Classroom una foto de Google Maps para que se guíen los papás de dónde queda, porque hay chicos que no compraron la short story, por ende iban a ir por primera vez al lugar donde ya dejé las short stories. Entonces, se supone que el alumno de quinto año ya tiene una edad suficiente para comunicarle al padre, chicos, por favor, tengan piedad de sus propios padres. Han ido papás que no saben qué es lo que no sabían qué es lo que tenían que encargar, ¿sí? Que no sabían dónde tenían que comprar la historia, el cuadernillo. Yo mandé una carátula, una foto de la carátula para que el alumno muestre al padre, porque se supone que los papás no están sentados al lado de ustedes, ¿sí? Para tener todo en claro. Entonces, a la noche o en algún momento, cuando ustedes charlan con los papás, digan, papá, la teacher mandó la dirección bien en Google Map o donde sea, y la carátula para que vos pidas bien. Me llamaban papás para decirme que no sabían qué era lo que tenían que comprar. Yo no tengo drama de atenderlo a los papás, pero el tema es que me dejan mal y dejan mal mi trabajo cuando yo mando mapa, mando notita, que tienen que comprar antes que vayan de vacaciones las personas de la librería. Mando la carátula. Entonces, por favor, sean responsables. ¿Sí? Estoy hablando, esto es para la gente que no comunicó, que no tienen 5 de comunicación con los padres. ¿Está? Yo no puedo estar mandando un WhatsApp cada 5 segundos a la casa. ¿Sí? ¿Está? Entonces, eso ténganlo en cuenta y sean más responsables, por favor, y charlen en la casa, avisen lo que se les pide que tienen que avisar. Yo igualmente mandé un WhatsApp diciéndole que por favor no se dejen estar con la compra de esto. No tenemos idea cuándo se van a tomar unos días, porque los chicos nos dijeron, avisa por favor que nosotros nos vamos a tomar unos días según la demanda de trabajo que tengamos. Pero no sabemos, no nos dijeron qué días se van a tomar, supongo por tema de seguridad y todo eso, no tengo idea. Pero o por tema de que no se organizaron todavía, así que bueno, esa es la idea. ¿Sí? Todo lo que yo les pueda avisar, les aviso, pero sean conscientes. Listo, muy bien. Con respecto a eso, ya estamos todos. Pónganse las pilas, la gente que no se puso las pilas para esta parte. Y quiero que se pongan a trabajar. ¿Yes? Ok. El que trabaja tiene buenos resultados. Y el que no, se va a ir quedando atrás. Una pena porque ya estamos en fifth year. El año que viene sería su último año que están conmigo. ¿Yes? Ok. Con nosotros acá en la academia. Bueno. The thing is like this. ¿Yes? Ok. We're going to talk on this unit 9. About future, about the future, about what you think, what your predictions, what are your predictions about the future? Yes. So and vocabulary about the future. Well, what about this picture? I want you to describe this picture at home. Yes, and think about, do you think this picture really reflects, the future society, our future society? Do you think cars will fly? Do you think the buildings could be different from now? Yes, what do you think about means of transport? Do you think they would be faster than now? Yes, they will be faster than now. They will change completely. What do you think about our way of communicating with the world? Yes, do you think it will change? Do you think we are going to become a better human being? I'm talking about that. Do you think we are going to change, really? Because yesterday I saw in the news that English people, yes, were allowed, yes, to go out, yes, to interact with other people, yes, and all the parks were full of rubbish, different kind of rubbish. So, I'm sad to say this, yes, but I think, yes, we are getting worse and worse, yes, because you know, if you see this news, I think you will understand what I am saying. Yes, okay. It was rubbish everywhere. There was rubbish everywhere. Yes, different kind of rubbish. So why didn't they take a bag and put the rubbish in it? Yes, okay. They haven't done this. Do you think it's a bit? It's very difficult for a human being to behave, to really take care about our environment, or we don't really care about anything. So I want you to think about it and think about our future generations. Do you think we are going to change? Do you think we are going to look after our environment, our planet? Well, sometimes I don't think so. Yes? All right. So, what about applications? What about the different apps people will use in the future? Do you think there could be more apps? Yes? Okay. Different kind of applications to become, for example, you know, I was thinking about it. Yes? But wait. these kind of applications. To fall in love, yes. To have a virtual love, yes. Or to become a kind of hologram. And for example, to be here, but at the same time, to be at the doctor, for example. Do you think these kind of applications will exist, yes, in the future? Yes? Do you think these different apps will help us? Yes? Will allow to be better human being or not? Or will we use this kind of application to become evil people? So I want you to think about that, yes? Because we are talking about the future, so we can imagine how our future will be, yes? Okay? Well, I will continue with the other. What about, these are regard futuristic apps. When you come back here, I'm going to put all this picture, I'm going to put all this picture on the board again. And we're going to talk about that, and I'm going to see and listen to your opinions, yes, okay? I listen to your opinions when you send me, because all the 3 minutes videos are for evaluating you in the oral part, yes? So I know, yes, what you think, yes? Listen, otra cosa, que me acuerdo. Todas las personas que no entregaron la short story, aprovechen ahora que se van a comprar el cuadernillo y pidan la short story, por favor, ¿sí? Porque no terminamos la short story, entonces, si no tenés evaluada literatura complementaria en la primer parte del año, tenés que tener en la segunda parte del año. O si no, te va a tocar rendir en el examen final la short story. Entonces, todas aquellas personas que no han hecho la short story van a tener incluido en el examen final, tipo previa, la parte de la short story. ¿Está? Así que está avisado esto, así que, por favor, a levantar esa nota, la gente que no presentó la short story, pidan, por favor, que compren los padres porque tienen que ser evaluados en la parte de literatura complementaria. O si no, les va a entrar en el examen final, sobre que ya es largo y tienen una hora y media nomás, le va a entrar la parte de literatura complementaria. Así que, don't be irresponsible. Yes? Ok? Bueno. Ese es el aviso que doy y la leyenda que voy a poner con respecto a las clases. ¿Está? Asistan a las clases porque voy a poner una leyenda ahora cuando mando. Por favor, charlar en casa, el tema de la asistencia, de mirar las clases a conciencia. ¿Yes? El que no mira, no está asistiendo a la clase. Bueno, ok. So, let's go to this picture again. Do you think everybody in the future, everybody, yes, you will we will have cameras everywhere. We will have surveillance, yes, everywhere. Do you think it could be right to be recorded all the time? Yes? In case of robberies, maybe. Yes? In case of pickpockets. So that could be a good way to stop criminals. Yes? Okay? Is it clear? Well, good. What about robots? Yes? Do you think robots will help us? Yes? Do you think it could be nice to have a robot at home? Yes? Helping? Yes? As a housekeeper or something like that? Do you think it could be safe to have a robot? So, do you think in a way they will help us? Or you won't trust? Yes? Okay, what do you think? Yes? Do you think they will get crazy? Yes. Something will make them feel insecure in a way and become crazy, become violent? Yes. Okay, I want you to think about this. Or do you think they will have an artificial intelligence. Yes, okay. Or do you think there will be a revolution between robots and human beings? I want you to think about this picture. Yes? What about means of transport? Do you think they will get worse or they will be better? Yes? Do you think they will be faster or slower? Yes? Do you think they could be more comfortable or less comfortable? Do you think you will be in less minutes? You will be faster in the place you want to be? So I want you to think about this picture because this is very interesting. And do you think everybody could be, do you think it could be possible to everybody? Do you think everybody could afford this kind of transport? Yes, okay. So I want you to think about it. Yes, okay. What about love? Yes, because when we are talking about the future, we have to talk about many things, about means of transport, about means of transport, about applications in the future, about love. So, do you think it could be possible, love between a robot and a human being? Yes? Do you think we will have more love or less love than what we have now? Yes? Okay? So, well, we were talking about that. What about this? Yes? Do you think robots will work faster than human beings? Indeed, in fact, they do. Yes? They work faster than the human being, than a human being, than a person, than a man. Yes? Because they can do more work in less hours. So how are we going to live, yes, without working? Yes, so I want you to think about that. Yes, do you think it could become true? Yes, to go to an interview? Yes, and sit next to a robot who is applying for a job? Yes, so who do you think is going to get the job? A robot or you? Yes? So, what about this? To fall in love, yes, using a kind of application. Yeah? But what happens if the application doesn't work? Yes? The application could be the guilty, yes, of your broken heart. So I want you to think about this because this is amazing. This is interesting. If we can think about this, if we can think about it, yes. All right. So I like this picture because for me this is true. Yes. Okay. You will lose your job, and who is the one who will be there sitting on your desk? The robot. Yes. Okay. What will you do? Yes. To maintain, to continue working on the same, on your same desk. So I want you to think about it. Yes, think about it. Yes. What's this? Okay, where's the waitress and the waiter there? Okay, it's a robot. So it is another person who is another robot who is in charge of your job. And what about the waitress? And what about the waiter? Where are going to work? Yes? Now they are poor. They don't have work. Yes? It could be impossible for them to continue living. They are going to be homeless. So there are many things to take into account when talking about future society. And that is our next unit, future society. So be prepared because now we are going to work on pages. I have a last one because I have prepared everything. What about nature? What about nature? Do you think we are going to enjoy our nature only virtually? Yes? I think yes. Yes, I think yes. Because as I told you before, we are not taking care of our environment. Yes? We continue polluting the air. We continue polluting the sea, the gardens, the parks, sorry, everywhere. Yes? So I think we are going to miss our nature, and the only possibility to feel nature again could be virtually. Is it clear? So we must think about everything. Yes? What about that? Using an application to become someone else, stealing other person's ID. Yes, okay. So other person's life. Yes, so I think that using applications could be useful, but on the other side, yes, it will be used for criminals. Yes, okay, by criminals. Yes, okay. And well, that was all. I hope you can talk about all these pictures. Imagine we are talking as I'm imagining, and I want you to think about it. Think about all the things I have talked and say at home, if you agree or if you disagree with me, all right? So let's go to the pages very quickly. Yes, all right. Qué divina esta picture, me encantan, eh? Okay, good. Okay, well, 1991 and 92. Okay, 1991 and 92. From the class book. Bueno, me fui un poco de tiempo con la charlada. Yeah, okay. Good, so let's go there, okay? Well, we have already talked about that because, you know, whenever we start a unit, I prepare some pictures for you to talk about it. What was wrong with the predictions? What was wrong with the predictions and what was right? Yes? When do you think they were made? Sorry. And can you think of any other famous predictions made in the past that have been wrong? One. A, television won't last because people will soon get tired of staring at a wooden box every night. B, there is no reason anyone could want a computer in their home. Video kills the radio. Yes, okay, there is a, but I think no, because people continue listening to the radio, people continue watching the Jagger box, yes, okay. So, but I think these predictions were wrong, yes, okay. Wait a minute, I want to check something, yes, okay. I have to write something here on my notes. Okay, well, so A is wrong because we continue watching television, and television is very important for us. Yes, okay, well, at least for people from my age. What do you think? Yes, okay. There is no reason anywhere good want a computer in their home. Everyone has a computer at home. Yes, one day the television will be used to fight and win elections, to educate our children in their own homes, and as shops for us to buy everything we need. Okay, this is true because, you know, many people are educated from television. Yes, we buy through television. Yes, the compras, for example, and everything. Yes, okay. Well, at home you have to make, well, we have already done these exercises because we have predicted about leisure activities, workplaces, transport, communication. Yes, okay. do it at home, yes? Maybe you can use the pictures I used before, because these pictures are also for you, okay? Are thought for you, yes? Okay, you are going to hear someone talking about going to a science exhibition. What sort of science exhibition would you be interested in going to and why? I'd like to be in this kind of exhibition, an exhibition about our future society, but about everything, not only robots, yes, but about everything, about, for example, an exhibition that has different parts, sections, about our society, about love, as I have talked before, about applications, about, education, yes, how we will be educated. Aided, yes. Will you, do you consider that we will be educated through internet? Yes. What is happening now? If you have to think about this reality, the reality we are living in, we can't see each other. Well, we can see each other through video conference and everything, but you can't come to the classes. Because there is a virus, and it is said that there will be more. So, how do you think students will be educated? People will be educated, not only, but in general. Yes, okay? Well, so let's listen. Let's go there. Yes, okay? It's on page 91, yes? Listen to Nela talking about her visit to an exhibition about robots. Why does she think the exhibition is important? Are you ready? There we are. Ready? Steady. And... ta-dum, ta-dum, go.
Unit 9. Future Society. Listening and Vocabulary Focus. Activity 4.
Last weekend, I went to see the Science Museum's Living Robot exhibition, Robotville, and I really enjoyed it. It was a collection of some extremely clever robots that have been made all over Europe. There are 6 zones you can visit, each showing different types of robots that have been designed to do different sorts of things. In total, there are 20 robots from many different countries. Many of them have just left their laboratories for the first time. You could see each robot in the place it might work in the future, you know, like a classroom or a doctor's surgery. And next to each robot was their inventor, so you could ask them all sorts of questions.
So you can see in this exhibition, you can see the robot interact where it was supposed to be, yes, in a surgery, in a classroom, and there was also its creator, yeah? So it could be, it may be very
interesting. And they were happy to answer them. They really enjoyed talking about the problems that they'd had and how they were going to improve the robots in the coming years. As well as seeing how new robots are being developed, you could also find out a bit about the history of robotics. I didn't know that the word robot was first used 90 years ago, not by a scientist, but in a play by a writer from Czechoslovakia, as it was called then. Something else that was surprising was the variety of robots they had on display. They were so different. I mean, when you talk about robots, most people think about a machine that looks a bit like a human being but moves in an awkward way and says things in a metallic sort of voice. At least that's what I think of. But at the exhibition, there were so many different types. There was even a robot fish, which I found totally unexpected. There were also robot dogs, which I thought was a bit strange because surely we want robots to help us with things like housework and stuff. Not to give us extra work looking after them, but they say...
Imagine a robot for teacher Ruth. A robot to help her, yes, to correct tests, correct revisions and everything. Do you think I could teach a robot, yes, to give classes, yes, as I want? Do you think a robot can replace Teacher Ruth in all the aspects? So that would be a question for your 3-minute video for next units.
But in the future, we'll want robots to keep us company as well as work for us. Apparently, the thing that older people complain about most isn't their health, but loneliness. And maybe robot pets can help with that. Or who knows, maybe even human-like companions? Wow. I think this exhibition is really important. It makes us aware of how our lives might change in the next decade or two. Robots will have a play.
It will help people. This is an advantage. Help people. Advantage. Help people who are very lonely. Yes, because loneliness can kill people. But this is what I think. So robots will be a kind of company, like pet robots, yes?
Based in our houses, doing lots of different jobs like cleaning. That's really what I'd thought before, but I didn't realise they would be able to do the cooking as well. Also, looking maybe a bit further ahead, they'll do routine jobs such as taking the dog for a walk or picking children up from school. We may even see them in our classrooms as teachers.
Okay, so they can help us doing housework. They can pick you up. So while they pick you up, your mother can be in her yoga class or your father can be playing football with their friends, with his friends. Okay, so that is an advantage, yes? But which is the disadvantage? Think disadvantage. Think about it. What about education?
It sounds like science fiction, but robots are already used in many places that we're not aware of. Mm-hmm. If you've seen any hospital dramas on TV, you've probably seen robots doing small operations.
Yes.
And we know that they are also used by the army to look for bombs or bring injured people away from dangerous places. This is really an exhibition that you mustn't miss. Especially if you're interested in how our world is going to look in the future. It's open until 6 every day, but it won't be running for much longer. It closes on the 4th of December. That's the day after tomorrow. Take my advice and get down to the Science Museum soon.
Okay, that is very interesting. I really would like to go there. Maybe because, you know, when you travel, yes, to other countries, especially Europe, there are many. I haven't traveled to the United States, but I think it's the same. Yes, if you go to, there are many museums, and you can see this kind of exhibitions, and it's really amazing. Yes, because from little children to old people, you can see everybody enjoying. Yes, all the material that is in exhibition, yes, okay? Well, so let's go, it helps, number 4, it helps to us to understand how our lives will be in the future, yes, and how our life will change, yes, okay? Number 5, I want you to listen again, rewind the video. Now is the time that you stop the video, you rewind it, listen again, and I will say the answers. 20, 2, inventor, 3, play, 4 boys, 5 fish, 6 health, 7 cooking, 8 teachers, 9 army, 10 4th of December. Yes? Okay. So, let's go to exercise 7. Exercise 7. I want you to tell me if you agree. I want you to go to exercise 8. Yes, you have print, you have cash. I want you to highlight all the words there. Yes, I was about to go to 7, but 7 is, we have been talking about the things, if you agree or disagree, you have to say at home. Print, cash, application, virtual, log, software, voice, password, monitors, yes, download, virus, and avatar. So I want you to complete. I really think that you already know many of these words. In case you don't know many of these words, use the dictionary, but try to complete, without using the dictionary, to complete this text, yes, about our computers and everything. Yes, now is the time that you stop the video, do the activities, and then listen to the answers. Number one, log. Yes,
okay.
Log on. Yes,
okay.
Log on. Okay, number two, inventor. Number three, play. Number four, boys. Number five, fish. Sorry. I am lost. Number one, log on. Number two, download. Number three, print. Number four, virtual. Number five, avatar. Number six, voice. Number seven, password. Number eight, monitor. Number nine, software. Number 10, applications. Number 11, virus. And number 12, crash. Exercise nine, you have to choose now. I want you to use
de la A a la Z, de la A a la Z,
vocabulary notebook, and write down all the words plus an example. Is it clear? All the words plus an example. Is it
very, very clear?
Okay, so remember to use
vocabulary de la A a la Z notebook.
Is it clear? Tal vez no te va a salir escrito ahí porque ya saqué la foto, pero te lo pongo acá. ¿Está? Y estás asistiendo a la clase, así que lo tenés que hacer.
Yes.
Click on.
Yes.
You have to click on the icon.
Yes.
Please, can you attach your document? This the document I asked in PDF, please.
Okay.
Oh, no. The Zoom is going to be impossible because I lost connection. The connectivity was awful. Bring up the menu. Yes, bring up the menu. Siempre hacemos con la ruedita. You bring up the menu. Yes, up or down. Generally down. Yes, or up. Yes, desplazar hacia abajo. Then you have scroll down. Yes, scroll down. Yes, okay. Perdón. Scroll down, desplazar. Yes, and bring up the menu. Yes, show the menu.
Yes, so you bring up the menu, you show the menu, and scroll down, desplazar, okay?
Well, choose a page,
yes,
okay? Which page do you choose?
Yes,
every day. Cut and paste,
yes,
okay? Ya lo saben a eso, así que me imagino que lo van a hacer bien ahora, okay? Exercise 9, on, click on, document, lost, up and down,
yes.
Exercise 4, bring up.
Yes,
okay. And scroll down, yes. And then cut and paste. Yes, is it clear? Well, can we go to page 92? I've already explained the homework. Yes, okay. You have three compositions. Composition number one and composition number 18 from the list that is in the cuadernillo. Then you have the article that is on page 35 from the exam Meister, exercise 5. You have all these pages. And two pages from the exam MISA, 54 and 55. Because I finish with this page and you will be free. Yes? Holidays are here. Yes, okay? What do you think your life will be in 5 years? We have already discussed our life in the future. But in 5 years, I think you will be at university. I think you will be rented or maybe you will be buying an apartment for studying there. You will be going to university in 5 years. Yes, okay. Now you have to read the prediction and discuss which ones you think will come true. Change the dates or those you disagree with. Okay? Read it.
Yes,
okay. And then, yes, we are going to go because one and two are for you to say if it is true, false, yes, okay. And I want you to go to the grammar part because we have future perfect continuous. How you form future perfect continuous? Will, have, and the past participle.
Yes.
Can we go to page 155? Yes, that is the grammar part. Yes, you have future perfect continuous. yes? We use the future perfect continuous to describe something. Acuérdate que siempre, lo que es continuo, yes? Something that will be completed before a definite time in the future. By the time a child is 5, it will have seen several thousand commercials. By this time tomorrow, I will have finished my classes, yes? By this time tomorrow, I will have sent you all the report cards, yes? Okay? Entonces, para este tiempo, yo estaré haciendo, habré hecho tal cosa, habré terminado, habré comido, habré finalizado. Is it clear? Y generalmente los adverbios son by this time tomorrow, by the time, yes? If I post it today, my car will definitely have arrived by Carla's birthday. Yes, okay, so this is the future perfect continuous. I will have studied. By this time tomorrow, you will have finished your school homework. Yes, okay, good. So can we go? Ahora quiero que hagas los ejercicios a conciencia. Yes, okay, are we there? Good. So, number 3. Yes, okay. 1, 2, exercise 1. 2, 4, 6, and 8. Exercise 2, 2, 3, 5, and 7. Yes. Exercise 4. 1, present. 2, past. 3, in or by. Yes, okay. In and by. Acordate, para present perfect continuous. By this time, yes. Exercise 5. We are going to listen, yes, okay, to Megan and Sam. Which prediction from activity 2 are they discussing? Okay? One exercise more and you are free to go.
Unit 9. Grammar focus, activity 5.
What do you think about the next prediction, Sam?
I think it's really unlikely. In 2020, we'll still be catching colds and suffering from heart attacks. There are so many different illnesses. It's going to be impossible to find ways of treating all of them.
But scientists are making such quick progress these days. Maybe not all of them. But I'm pretty sure they'll have found cures for most of them by then, aren't you?
By 2020? No. Maybe 2050.
You're such a pessimist.
No, I'm a realist. It's different.
Do you think there is a difference between being pessimistic and realistic? I think yes, yes. I wasn't being pessimistic, but I was being realistic on the things I've seen, yes, okay? Well, wait a minute, yes, okay? Wait a minute. Yes, okay, exercise 6, be catching, yes, okay. 2, suffering, yes. 3, have found. Yes. Do you think, by this time next year, they will have found a cure for this illness? Yes, for this virus? Yes, okay. I haven't got, that is very sad, but I haven't got an optimistic point of view now. Yes, number 4, bye. Yes, and now you finish with exercise 8. Stop the video, do the activities, and then listen to the answer. Will have finished. Won't be leaving. Won't have improved. Will still be paying. And won't be doing. Yes. Okay. That's all, because you have the future perfect continuous, yes, okay? I will be leaving, Yes, this is the future continuous, and then you have the future perfect continuous, that is this one. Yes, I won't have, yes, lived. I won't have finished. Yes, write own examples in your notebook, please. By this time this year, what you will be doing by this time this year. By this time this year, I will be finishing the classes. I will have prepared myself for holidays. Yes? Well, that's all. Yes, I want you to enjoy. I was thinking about the holidays and everything. It will be a different holidays for you now, because you will have to stay at home. Well, you have to think about our future, how we can change our society and everything about what we have taught in this class. Well, you have everything. You have the holiday homework, and happy winter holidays. See you after these 2 weeks. Bye-bye, fifth year. See you next class after holidays. Bye-bye.